Hello there, this is Letta Brouwer and you are now watching Violin Lounge TV, where you learn to improve your violin and viola playing with joy. And today we're going to talk about something lots of people suffer from when they consider starting to play the violin or viola, or they are already playing but something is holding them back from playing. And in Dutch we call that smoesjes, and that is Dutch for excuses. Well, let's talk about six common smoesjes that people have for not playing the violin or viola, and which holds them back from a lot of joy. And I hate to see it when people are holding themselves back while they really want it. They actually want it, but they're not doing it for some reasons that aren't even valid. So let's go through them. The first one, I hear this a lot. I don't know or I don't think I've got talent or feeling to play the violin or viola. Well, first of all, you don't know, because if you've never had any music education, how can you possibly know if you're talented for it? Some people say, I haven't had any music education because I'm not talented. Well, if you didn't have that education, then you couldn't possibly know if you have talent for it. And secondly, you don't need to have lots of talent to be able to play the violin and viola beautifully. I think it's something that every average person can learn. It's something that you can learn. And with one person it goes faster than with the other, but I think it's possible. And maybe you won't become a world soloist, but that's maybe not even your goal. And yeah, everybody has to work for it. Even people who are extremely talented have also got to practice and do the work. So it doesn't really make a difference. So besides questioning if you are talented, because a lot of people think they are not, and it's just based on nothing, you could question if you would be averagely talented. Then you can still learn a lot and have a lot of fun, so what does it matter? Okay, number two, I'm too old. Well, you're never too old. You can always learn. Well, you can start now or you can start later. That's the choice you have. So in a later moment, you will always be older than now. So if you make the decision now, then I would say start now, because you will never get younger again. And you can perfectly learn something when you're older. I've taught a beginning retired violinist that started learning at the age of 60 or 65. And they also managed to get good results. So some people, if they are retired, they take this as a chance. Now I've got time and the money to start playing, and that's great. If that's how it went, then it's okay. Then number three, I don't have time. Well, time is something that everybody has kind of the same amount of, namely 24 hours a day, to be exactly. And if you really want it, then make a priority of it, and maybe you can reschedule some other things or change your priority list and put that learning to play the violin or viola a bit higher on that priority list if you really like to do it. So most of the times, well, you never hear people saying, I don't have time to brush my teeth. So playing like 15, maybe 30 minutes a day shouldn't be that problem, but really look seriously into that. How am I spending my time now? And how could I do that and make place for maybe 50 minutes, 30 minutes violin playing? And then smoesje number four, I can't find a teacher. Well, everybody with a computer, with a webcam and microphone can find a teacher. Because there are a lot of people now teaching via Skype. I've got very positive experience with teaching via Skype. And you can also easily record the lessons. It's a great way to work, and it has all the advantages of a normal violin lesson, because you can see and hear each other. So if you have a smartphone or a tablet or a computer with a webcam, just one of them, and you can just cherry pick teachers from all around the world to take lessons with. Then number 5, I don't have the money. Well, this is the kind of the same as I don't have time. What are you spending it on now? And could you make some changes there to have some more space in your schedule and also in your wallet to go play violin and also search for maybe cheaper alternatives. You don't need a weekly lesson of an hour, for example. You can rent a violin instead of buying it right away. And there are several things in which you can learn to play the violin or viola in a way that doesn't have to cost you a lot of money. And then number 6, I'm left-handed. Well, I've got 2 things to say about it. First, with your left hand, you do all the difficult stuff in violin playing. So I would say that being left-handed can be an advantage. And secondly, there are also violins on the market that are the other way around. So that everything is built in the other way around. So you can play it with your right hand and bow with your left hand. So these are the 2 options. But with violin playing, you do difficult stuff with every hand. So I don't think it really matters if you're right-handed or left-handed. Maybe if you're right-handed, your bowing technique will be a bit better than with someone who's left-handed. Maybe if you're left-handed, your fingering and your intonation will be a bit better than someone who's right-handed. But playing the violin is so different from usual activities that most of the times you don't even see a difference. So that's certainly not something that should hold you back. I hope maybe I have switched a button in your mind that said that you couldn't play, and maybe you've got the motivation now and to start playing. So what are you waiting for? Okay, well, this was my little video with the 6 smooshes, and maybe you recognize some of them. Thank you for watching Violin Lounge TV. If you have questions for me on violin or viola playing, just post them in the comments below or send me an email directly, info@violinlounge.com. If you like this video, then just click on like. And if you'd like to see more videos, then just go to violinlounge.com and you will find tons of valuable videos. I wish for you to really start playing better today than tomorrow, and to express your unique beauty and your unique voice through the violin. Happy playing! Bye bye! Join me in the free workshop Weight versus Pressure, where I teach you to play the violin effortless with a beautiful tone. Go to www.violinlounge.com/free-workshop to get direct access to this workshop. I'm sure it will be worth it.